nestled along the gigantic Mahanadi River. Are many villages where the spirit of Ram exists in everything and everyone. It is not just in the pillar of the temples or the walls of the house. Rocks on the road or fabric of the clothes. But also on every inch of a human skin. This is a story of devotion, revolt, and equality. This is a story of the Ramnami community. Ramnami is a Hindu sect, different from the traditional Hindu belief system. What sets them apart is their worship of a single formless god they address as Ram. This Ram isn't the Ram from the pages of Ramayana, but something more ethereal.
कोई शुभ समय या शुभ ग्रह नक्षत्र नहीं है क्योंकि नहीं है हम जिस समय रामनाम की स्मरण कर ले वो समय हमारे लिए शुभ हो जाता है और जिस जगह पर हम रामनाम को उच्चारण हो जाए वो जगह पवित्र कहीं भी
For the Ramnamis, Ram exists in every aspect of life, and to show their devotion, they tattoo his name all over their body. The life of a Ramnami is incredibly simple. They rise with the sun, embracing each day with humility and devotion. They live in simple modest houses and wear white cotton clothes with Ram Ram written all over it. They also wear headgears made of peacock feather that adds a touch of color to their attire. Since the main occupation of most Ramnami is farming, they spend their days either working on the field or chanting dohas from Ramcharitramanas, the only holy book you will find in their houses. As they chant in groups, each Ramnami uses a ghungru to maintain the rhythm. Their belief in a formless divine is so profound that even their temples do not have statues of God. Much like the Ramnami's modest lifestyle, these temples are simple, painted with white and inked with the word Ram Ram in black. But what's truly exceptional is the lack of doors and windows, symbolizing that the temple is open to all, offering shelter to anyone in need. The resonance of Ram Ram carries a profound impact even after death. Unable to see the skin inscribed with the word Ram Ram being burned to ashes, the Ramnamis do not cremate their departed loved ones. Instead, they lay them to rest in coffins, honoring their faith even in the final moment. And returning the divine energy back to the soil from where it came, completing the cycle of life. The lives of the Ramnamis wasn't always this simple. For over 200 years, they faced caste-based discrimination and were prohibited from entering the temple. Fueled by devotion towards Ram, a man named Purshuram chose to rebel. he inscribed the word Ramnam on his skin and converted his body into a temple. Witnessing the act of devotion, many more followed, which led to the formation of the Ramnami community in the 18th century. In a world where discrimination based on caste, creed, color, and gender still lingers, this community is a living example of equality. Despite enduring discrimination, the Ramnami respond with love. Instead of inflicting pain on others, they choose to endure it themselves by tattooing the name of God all over their body. And converting this very painful act of devotion into an awe-inspiring story. This isn't a story of defiance, but a testimony of love and faith in the face of adversity. This is my story of the Ramnami community.
तार जल्दी जल्दी काम कर देता है तो वो पुल जल्दी टूट जाता है अब कोई ठेकेदार मजबूत कमाते हैं तो वो पुल बहुत दिन टिकता है वैसे आत्मा जल्दी जल्दी काम करोगे तो जल्दी समाप्त हो जाएगी
जो चीज हमें बुरा लगता है वो हम दूसरे के ऊपर लागू ना करें ताकि उसको बुरा ना लगे यही प्रेम है यही भाव है यही भजन है